BMW Concept Z4. It is giving you a hint, a very close hint, at what the production car will look like sometime next year. It is also part of this new chapter in the development of our form language. So again here, very few lines. The lines that are there are carefully chosen. I'll take you through them in a couple of seconds. But first of all, I think SSE4, you will see that the car has become a lot more dynamic than any Z4 before. As part of our development for the BMW form language, we also want to make sure that each of our vehicles within our range will have a clear identifiable character. So while we're actually choosing to reduce our form language, we believe we can increase the emotion and the character of the vehicles. And if you allow me to take you through this design very quickly, then starting at the front, of course, you'll see a very, very dynamic front end. The grille also wide and low, because this is part of the sporty range of our program, of course. You see a new solution inside this grille, this mesh grille, which can also be traced back to our history. We've had kidney-shaped grilles for a long time, for let's say 100 years, but in various shapes and forms, and mesh grilles were part of our history as well. This is our new interpretation of that. Then the headlamps are completely new to the brand, I would say. So overall, we have a completely new facial expression. They're actually arranged in a more vertical manner, adding to the dynamic of the front view, we believe. And that will be something that will be unique to the concept of the Z4. Then if we go to the body side, there is really only one line that matters, I would say, and it's this line. And it turns from being a bonnet shut line over here, we have a clamshell bonnet, into a rear fender line. And actually what happens around that line is a very complicated sculpture that looks easy at first. But when you walk around the car later on, you'll see that it's actually, in terms of surfacing and modeling, quite sophisticated. But what it is intended to do is it creates emotion, of course, through how the surfaces are handled. In the body side, there is only one air outlet, and that tends to shape the entire body as the airflow would. The rear view of the car, of course, looks very low, very wide. Not so easy to do for an open-top car, but something that you will see from us then also in the production car next year. In the interior, like I said, we managed to clean up quite considerably. All the elements that you need to control the car are neatly grouped in a couple of islands. The cockpit is really centered around the driver here, both in geometry and in color material. We selected some very interesting color materials for this vehicle, and you can experience also some of the new user interface that you will have in production later on. So that we believe would be a good way to kick off what I believe is going to be a fantastic weekend here in Pebble Beach. I'm very much looking forward together with you to look at all these other fantastic and unique pieces of design and even drive some of them. So I believe this is going to be a fantastic weekend, and I'm really looking forward to hearing your reactions to our contribution to this celebration of style and car design and passion that is the Pebble Beach Concours d'Elegance. Thank you very much.